The Believer's Walk of Faith is paid for by Bill Winston Ministries partners and viewers.
Canaan represents the best of God. Moving into Canaan, you're switching to a higher system now. Canaan is the ultimate system for producing everything that you desire and can produce it in a day. There's no situation that God cannot get you out of in 24 hours. We're going in and we're going to get what belongs to you. Your only ticket is faith. The Holy Spirit, put it up there, please. 2 Corinthians 13 and 14. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the what? Communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Now, what did I tell you that meant communion meant? The word communion in the Greek is koinonia, spelled with a K. Koinonia. And it means one that is close to you. It's almost like an intimate closeness, like my wife and I. But that's the Holy Spirit. And he's been given to you, and he'll be with you forever. How do I know that? All I have to do is go in here and look at John chapter 14, and let's try verse 15. He said this. He said, if you love me, keep my commandments. Watch this. And I will pray the Father, and he'll give you what? Another comforter. What will he do? He'll abide with you forever. Put it up there in the Amplified translation, and let's look at that word comforter again. Now, we went through all of this. He said, and I'll ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter, counselor, helper, intercessor, advocate, strengthener, standby, and he may remain with you, come on, forever. See, I'm going to send you into a war zone, but you're not going to get hurt. If you go and look at E.W. Kenyon has a little book called The Blood Covenant. And it shows that anybody that's under that covenant of God, that covenant of Abraham, anybody that's under that never gets touched. Every baby comes out perfect. There are no miscarriages. There were none. All you have to do is look at the history of the Jews. There was none. They went up to fight a battle of Jericho, remember? And because Achan stole the tithe, the next battle of Ai, they lost 36 men. Why did Joshua fall on his face? Because nobody's supposed to get touched. Can you imagine a war and nobody get touched? I'm just saying that's how you can live. But this promise comes by what? Faith. But if you've never heard it, you'll never develop the faith for it. So I'm teaching you right now that, one, you'll never get sick again. Now, that doesn't mean you go out here, drink a whole fifth of Jack Daniels. Come on now. Come on. Smoke 20 rolls of reefer. Come on now. Come on. See, it don't mean that. It means that you've got some sense. I'm not leaving any rock unturned. I got to say all of this. Now, let's talk about this, because what makes faith flow? And what I said to you was righteousness. Righteousness. Now, what is righteousness? It is by faith. I think it's Romans chapter 5, verse 1. Put it up in Amplified, please. Therefore, since we are what? Justified, acquitted, come on, declared, what else? Made righteous. All right, now. So you're made righteous by faith. So he says you're righteous, say I'm righteous. And I am the righteousness of God. In Christ Jesus. So he's made you that way. Now, what we said is for righteousness to flow, I need to know who I am. And I said something in the first service. Your rich inheritance comes in proportion to your new identity. Your rich inheritance comes only in proportion to your new identity. Now, what was the inheritance? The promised land. Where were they? Still in the wilderness. What did the two spies say? Let us go up at once and possess it. We are well able to overcome it. What did the others say? We can't do it. We're in our own sight as, notice, their image of who they saw themselves to be kept them out of the promised land of God. And I'm saying your image, well, I'm disadvantaged. You are not disadvantaged. You are advantaged. You are more advantaged than anybody who's advantaged. Now, let me tell you where that really pays off. See, people go to work, but you got to define work according to God. See, work is not just I'm going out to, you know, tote that bar and lift that bale. That is not work. Work includes manifesting what God has placed in you. See, that's why a woman, before she delivers, goes into what? Labor. Why? Because she's about to bring forth something. And the same thing about work. Every day you go there, you ought to be excited because you're about to see what God put in you. Say amen to that. And the thing about righteousness is righteousness brings back a sense of boldness. Look what it says up here. And put Proverbs chapter 30 and verse 30. Look what he says here. He said, a lion which is strongest among beasts, he turns not away from any. So notice, a lion has a nature of a lion. And what is his nature? He won't turn away from any. Why? He thinks he's the man. He's the man. I don't need to turn away from you because I can whoop you. I'm putting that in 42nd 7th Street. Okay, but I can whoop you. But watch that, watch this. And he knows he can. Is he the biggest?
No.
Does he think he is?
Yeah.
It doesn't make any difference. You may not look the biggest, but you think you're the biggest. And all you got to do is think that, and God can walk through you and do that. All you got to do is think that. I mean, I know a guy. This guy was not the best looking guy I've ever seen in my life. Now, I'm not talking about people up and down. So I'll just use an example. But he always had, you know, can I go back for a minute? He always had a fine sister on his hand. You know me. And I'm amazing. Well, how will he do that? Well, he thinks he's cute. When I was a kid in high school, Willie thought he was the finest thing that ever hit the face of the earth. Really? And used to come over and borrow my shirts and didn't take a bath. So when I got it back, man, I said, I just gave it back to him. Man, just don't take it. But anyway, Willie thought me and you couldn't tell Willie he wasn't cute. But I said, man, he look at him again, man. He got, I said, man, he thinks he's the finest thing that ever hit the face of the earth. Well, the lion thinks he's the strongest thing that ever hit there. And you ought to think you're the ruler over this earth. Say amen to that. Now look at Proverbs 28 and verse 1. I don't know why I'm over here, but I'm over here for a reason. Verse 1. Look what it said. The wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous, come on, is bold as a lion. See, when that boldness is not there, something's wrong. And when you can be easily talked out of your health, something's wrong. Come on, when you can be easily discouraged because you ain't got some money, something's wrong. But the righteous are bold. They know they belong to the living God. They know that they're a child of God and an heir of God. Man, you can say in your worst financial situation, I'll never be broke another day in my life. By this time tomorrow, I'm going to have some money. And God will manifest money in your life. What we're coming up on. We are coming up on this conference. So righteousness, you got to understand, there are two spirits. Lord have mercy. That spirit of want and poverty. And these spirits are designed to one of them to walk with you and one of them to keep you. Keep you broke and keep you making wrong decisions. So I'm coming up with a conference, see? So unrighteousness allows those spirits to take over. And the spirit said, you don't need to go to that conference. When that conference is going to have the very needed thing, because because, folks, you can get a revelation of your healing in a business conference. Because God's not limited about who's speaking. How about creative ideas? Righteousness will receive it. See, when a person is unrighteous or they have sin consciousness, they have no spiritual initiative. That's why they stay in the same broke place. Because the initiative isn't there. God, see, who is God? He is Elohim. Elohim means creator. Now, he's creating 24/7. And guarantee he's speaking to his people to create. Say amen to that. And if you're working with God, he's busy telling you something new to do. But unrighteousness can't receive it. You remember the story of the prodigal son, Luke chapter 15. You remember that, right? So what did he do? Prodigal son said, I want mine now. Goes out, spends it all, ends up feeding hogs. Then he said, hey, I'm going home. He said, hey, to be a servant in daddy's house is better than this. I'm headed home. He started going home now. His father runs, sees him, runs, hugs him, kisses him. He's still smelling like a hog. And then he says, son, who's dead, he's alive again. He was lost, he's found. Come on in. Let's have a party. Let's have a celebration. Get the best robe. Put it on him. Put shoes on his feet. Ring on his finger. Now, let's kill the fatted calf. In other words, let's shed some blood to eliminate everything that he had done in his past. Let's wipe it out from the records. But not only that, let's wipe out the consciousness of what he did. Let's take the blood and apply it to his brain. Let's create new brain cells. Come on now, this is all what you can do with the anointing. And the anointing is on that blood. Let's create, because I remember when I'd hurt my knee, went over there and said, hey, Pastor, we're putting this machine on there. I said, what does that do? It said it destroys the memory that's in the cells concerning your knee being hurt. I said, is that right? I said, them cells can remember that? So, oh, yeah. Said, it turns up. I said, well, if that machine can do it, the anointing can do it. Say amen. And it will wipe out, folks. I've had people say, hey, I went to my hometown. Hey, you remember when we used to steal them hubcaps? And I was trying to remember. I had to agree with you. I said, yeah, man. I remember. But I didn't remember. I didn't remember. He can make you forget the terrible parts of your past, man. That's what cripples a lot of people. It's that the enemy brings it up and cycles it through your mind over and over. Say amen to that. So, if you don't play ball with the devil, the next step or the next stop is the furnace. If you don't play ball with the devil, now he's sending you, God's sending you into places that they may not like you. I just read that. Am I right about it? But that doesn't make any difference. You're not coming there to be liked. You're coming there to transform the environment. Now, you can't transform it unless you're transformed. Say amen to that. All right. So, if you don't play ball with the devil, his next stop for you is the furnace. Now, what do I mean by furnace? He begins to heat it up. Now, how hot did he heat up the furnace for the three Hebrews? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Okay, Abednego. All right. Answered and said unto the king, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer you in this matter. Watch this. If it be so, the God whom we serve, he is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. And he what? He what? Now, do you have to say it?
Yes.
Say yes. You have to say it. I don't care what the doctor says. I don't care anybody says. If they're still working on you, you still got to say it. Say amen. Just don't let it come out of your mouth. Now, I don't care who don't like this. I'm teaching you how this thing works. You will never rise any higher than you're willing to confess. So you gotta say, I'll never be sick another day in my life. You gotta say something. Say amen to that. And what happened is the church many times been talked out of this because they're trying to keep members. But they feel if they say stuff like that, somebody who's in that profession, whatever, will leave. Well, leave, praise God. What I'm trying to do is educate the body of Christ. And I realize that I gotta go through the furnace sometimes to get to you, but I'm willing to go through it. Because you're going to be in promised land. You're not going. You're going to be there. You're going to say amen. It's time for, especially black Christians, it's time for the Christian business and black Christians to stop being the smallest business in every city. No, 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 no. You are the children of the living God. And for you, it's for your children, your children's children. Now we're going to break this mess up, because I'm going to preach it. Now, okay. All right. Let me just finish this. So, the next stop is a furnace. Why? Because you didn't bow. You didn't bow. See, you somehow you compromised, or not you, but somebody compromised trying to get the favor of the king. But the king is running in ungodliness. The king has been saturated by the enemy and trying to. So now what I got to do is I got to go up against the forces of darkness. But God promised you that you are will overcome. I said he promised you. First John chapter 5 and verse 4 said that we are overcomers. Look what he says here. He said in 1 John chapter 4, for whatsoever is born of God, are you born of God? Then what are you going to do? Overcome the world. Anything that they throw at you, you're going to overcome it. I don't care what they call you. I don't care how they try to snatch your paycheck. I don't care how they try to fire you, because you're going to end up owning the place just like Joseph and hiring them to work for you. Can I keep going? So the next step is the furnace. Now, what does he control? The enemy tried to control the curse. So he has tried to send the curse out on you. Look what it says in Psalm chapter 73, and I'll start at verse 3, I think it is. Praise God. But just look at this. Watch this. For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the what? Prosperity of the wicked. Keep going. For there are no bands in their death, but their strength is firm. Keep going. They are not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men. That enemy can direct the plague. He can direct some sickness. He'll try to put sickness on somebody who's moving out and so forth. But that's just the furnace. What you got to do is understand that's just the furnace. That you are an overcomer. That you're not going to let this furnace turn you around. And what he did in the furnace, he heated it up 7 times hotter than normal. Well, what is 7 times? Watch this. How hot does a fire have to be to burn you? Come on. Can a match burn you? Now, it's hotter than a match. A match is about 1,000 degrees. But a furnace to forge steel is about 9,000. Why? Because they got to bend steel. They got to fit that steel on your door of your car. They got to fit that horseshoe thing. So they heat it up in a furnace. And that furnace is hotter than anything else. But the furnace is designed that if you don't know God, you can't go through that furnace. Because only God can get in that furnace with you. Say amen. And I'm telling you, it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13, this is for anybody who's going through. There is no temptation taken you, but such is common to man. But God is faithful. faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted, tested, or tried above that you're able, but will with the temptation also, come on, make a way to escape, that you may be able to what? To bear it. See, Job was going through it, but in Job chapter 13, put it on the board, please. In Job chapter 13, when he got to his last, he didn't know what else to do. He said, though he slay me, yeah, well, I trust him. And let me tell you, he brought Job out. Look what it says over here when God was reading the riot act to Job. Further over in the book of Job, verse 4, chapter 40, verse 7. He said, gird up thy loins like a man. Let me tell you what he said in Bill Winston's translation. Man up. Man up. You ain't going through nothing. Man up. And I'm telling you, you think you're the only one that went through that? Satan has no new trick. He's taking people through the same thing. But I'm telling you right now, man up. Your days, your best days are ahead of you. God is in that fire with you. You will not burn. You will not falter. You will not lose out. You will not be ashamed. Just man up. God is about to bring you through.
Well, I trust that you were blessed by that powerful message. Now, this word is not designed to just, you know, just give you a word. It's designed to empower you so that you can do some things you've never done before. Now, here is a part of this particular message you want to strictly make note of. Your inheritance comes only in proportion to your new identity. You see, once we were born again, we're children of God. We're no longer what we were. As a matter of fact, as you go on in the teachings, you're going to see that God says in the scriptures that we've been born from above, that we have his same nature on the inside. So you don't have the same nature as people who don't know God. You're different. Now you got to walk in that new identity. Now, the Bible kind of likens us to a lion, if you will. So a lion, one of the things about him is he's bold. I mean, a lion can growl and you feel the ground shake. I'm telling you. So this lion, now he may not be the biggest thing in the jungle, but he thinks he is. So around you may be all kinds of giants, all kinds of giant opportunities, giant obstacles and so forth. Now in your own natural self, before you got born again, you couldn't overcome that. But now you're a giant slayer. That's what you're looking for. Your stuff is wherever it looks impossible. Guaranteed your stuff is right there. Praise God. But you as a lion, the Bible says in Proverbs 30:30, turn not away from any. You are strong and very courageous. Isn't that powerful? Now today's message is entitled Entering into Canaan. Now I'm offering a 4-part teaching on entering into Canaan. Plus I'm putting together with that a book called Training for Reigning. Now that's a bundle that you're going to get. I mean, this is a life transforming bundle here that I want you to order. I mean, if you're looking to wake something up inside of you so that you, that fear will go away, you'll feel strong and very courageous. This is a teaching for you. Get this teaching, guaranteed it'll change your life. Well, this is Bill Winston. Until next time, we love you and keep walking by faith.
Today's series, Entering into Canaan, is available in its entirety on CD or MP3, on DVD or MP4. To order, call 1-800-711-9327 or contact us online at billwinston.org. Want additional resources to help you grow? Order Reigning in Canaan Special Bundle, which includes Entering into Canaan 4-part series and Dr. Winston's mini book, Training for Reigning. Order this dynamic bundle today.
I came to announce that this is the last day. And you're going to go through what you've been going through. This is it.
Well, hello, this is Bill Winston. I'm introducing my book. It's called The Kingdom of God in You. Now, this book was put out years ago, and this is the revised edition. I've added some things to it. Now, I believe that this is one of the most important readings in the body of Christ. In other words, when you see Jesus and opening up with his ministry, all he preached was a kingdom. He preached it, taught it, and demonstrated it, because that's what it's all about. That's why he said, pray thy kingdom come, thy will be done, where? In earth, as it is in heaven. Now, when you're talking about the kingdom of God, notice the word king and dumb. And dumb is domain. And what is a domain? It is a territory under the government of a sovereign or a sovereign ruler. Now, that's what is needed today, because the Bible says that the kingdom of God is in you. If you're born again, the kingdom, whole kingdom, has come inside of you. Now, wherever you go, you express that sovereign government. Once you read this book and get a revelation of the kingdom of God in you, you'll speak with authority that you never know you have. And watch the demonstration of God, because his whole government, angels, anointing, is backing what you say. Isn't it powerful? The kingdom of God in you. This will change your life forever. It'll take you from the bottom to the top. Guaranteed. It's the kingdom of God in you.
Doctors Bill and Veronica Winston are dedicated to seeing lives changed through the power of prayer. Our loving and highly trained prayer ministers are ready to pray and agree with you. We know that prayer can turn around any situation in your life. Contact us by phone at 1-877-543-9443 or submit your prayer request online at billwinston.org/prayer. Follow us on Periscope and Facebook to join us for our regular live prayer sessions. We want to thank our partners who have made this prayer call center possible. Together, we are transforming lives throughout the world. If you are not a partner, we encourage you to pray about joining us in partnership and be a part of the wonderful work that God is doing through this ministry. We love you and look forward to praying and partnering with you. The mission of Bill Winston Ministries is to preach the gospel of the kingdom throughout the world. We invite you to become a partner and join Dr. Bill Winston as he trains believers how to live independent of this world system and have dominion over it. Thank you, Bill Winston Ministry partners and viewers, for your continuous support of the Believer's Walk of Faith broadcast.
Now remember, you need faith to get to your destiny. So don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell so that you don't miss any of our videos. This is Bill Winston. I love you. And keep watching.
to a higher system now. Canaan is the ultimate system for producing everything that you desire and can produce it in a day. There's no situation that God cannot get you out of in 24 hours. We're going in and we're going to get what belongs to you. Your only ticket is faith. The Holy Spirit, well, put it up there, please. 2 Corinthians 13 and 14. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the what? Communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Now, what did I tell you that meant communion meant? The word communion in the Greek is koinonia, spelled with a K. Koinonia. And it means one that is close to you. It's almost like an intimate closeness, like my wife and I. But that's the Holy Spirit. And he's been given to you and he'll be with you forever. How do I know that? All I have to do is go in here and look at John chapter 14 and let's try verse 15. He said this. He said, if you love me, keep my commandments. Watch this. And I will pray the Father and he'll give you what? Another comforter. What will he do? He'll abide with you forever. Put it up there in the Amplified translation. And let's look at that word comforter again. Now, we went through all of this. He said, and I'll ask the Father, and he will give you another comforter, counselor, helper, intercessor, advocate, strengthener, standby, and he may remain with you, come on, forever. See, I'm going to send you into a war zone, but you're not going to get hurt. If you go and look, E.W. Kenyon has a little book called The Blood Covenant. And it shows that anybody that's under that covenant of God, that covenant of Abraham, anybody that's under that never gets touched. Every baby comes out perfect. There are no miscarriages. There were none. All you have to do is look at the history of the Jews. There was none. They went up to fight a battle of Jericho, remember? And because Achan stole the tithe, the next battle of Ai, they lost 36 men. Why did Joshua fall on his face? Because nobody's supposed to get touched. Can you imagine a war and nobody get touched? I'm just saying that's how you can live. But this promise comes by what? Faith. But if you've never heard it, you'll never develop the faith for it. So I'm teaching you right now that one, you'll never get sick again. Now that doesn't mean you go out here, drink a whole fifth of Jack Daniels. Come on now. Come on. Smoke 20 rolls of reefer. Come on now. Come on. See, it don't mean that. It means that you got some sense. I'm not leaving any rock unturned. I got to say all of this. Now, let's talk about this, because what makes faith flow, and what I said to you was righteousness, righteousness. Now, what was righteousness? It is by faith. I think it's Romans chapter 5, verse 1. Put it up in Amplified, please. Therefore, since we are what? Justified, acquitted, come on, declared, what else? Made righteous. All right, now. So you're made righteous by faith. So he says you're righteous. Say, I'm righteous. And I am the righteousness of God. In Christ Jesus. So he's made you that way. Now, what we said is for righteousness to flow, I need to know who I am. And I said something in the first service. Your rich inheritance comes in proportion to your new identity. Your rich inheritance comes only in proportion to your new identity. Now, what was the inheritance? The promised land. Where were they? Still in the wilderness. What did the two spies say? Let us go up at once and possess it. We're well able to overcome it. What did the others say? We can't do it. We're in our own sight as, notice there, image of who they saw themselves to be kept them out of the promised land of God. And I'm saying your image, well, I'm disadvantaged. You are not disadvantaged. let me tell you where that really pays off. See, people go to work, but you got to define work according to God. See, work is not just I'm going out to, you know, tote that bar and lift that bale. That is not work. Work includes manifesting what God has placed in you. See, that's why a woman, before she delivers, goes into what? Labor. Why? Because she's about to bring forth something. And the same thing about work. Every day you go there, you ought to be excited because you're about to see what God put in you. Say amen to that. And the thing about righteousness is righteousness brings back a sense of boldness. Look what it says up here, and put Proverbs chapter 30 and verse 30. Look what it says here. He said, a lion which is strongest among beasts, he turns not away from any. So notice, a lion has a nature of a lion. And what is his nature? He won't turn away from any. Why? He thinks he's the man. He's the man. I don't need to turn away from you because I can whoop you. I'm putting that in 42nd 7th Street. Okay, but I can whoop you. But watch that. Watch this. And he knows he can. Is he the biggest?
No.
Does he think he is?
Yeah.
It doesn't make any difference. You may not look the biggest, but you think you're the biggest. And all you got to do is think that, and God can work through you and do that. All you got to do is think that. I know a guy, this guy was not the best looking guy I've ever seen in my life. Now, I'm not talking about people up and down, so I'll just use an example. But he always had, you know, can I go back a few minutes? He always had a fine sister on his hand, you know what I mean? And I mean, how will he do that? Well, he thinks he's cute. When I was a kid in high school, really thought he was the finest thing that ever hit the face of the earth. Really? And used to come over and borrow my shirts and didn't take a bath, so when I got it back, man, I just gave it back to him. Man, just don't take it. But anyway, Willie thought me, you couldn't tell Willie wasn't cute. But I said, man, he look at him again, man. He got, I said, man, he think he the finest thing that ever hit the face of the earth. Well, the lion thinks he's the strongest thing that ever hit there. And you ought to think. Proverbs 28 and verse 1. I don't know why I'm over here, but I'm over here for a reason. Verse 1. Look what it said. The wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous, come on, is bold as a lion. See, when that boldness is not there, something's wrong. And when you can be easily talked out of your health, something's wrong. Come on, when you can be easily discouraged because you ain't got some money, something's wrong. But the righteous are bold. They know they belong to the living God. They know that they're a child of God and an heir of God. Man, you can say in your worst financial situation, I'll never be broke another day in my life. By this time tomorrow, I'm going to have some money. And God will manifest money in your life. Now, here's what we we're coming up on. We're coming up on this conference. So righteousness, you got to understand, there are two spirits. Lord have mercy. That spirit of want and poverty. And these spirits are designed to one of them to walk with you and one of them to keep you. Keep you broke and keep you making wrong decisions. So I'm coming up with a conference, see? So unrighteousness allows those spirits to take over. And the spirit said, you don't need to go to that conference. When that conference is going to have the very needed thing, because, folks, you can get a revelation of your healing in a business conference. Because God's not limited about who's speaking. How about creative ideas? Righteousness will receive it. See, when a person is unrighteous or they have sin consciousness, they have no spiritual initiative. That's why they stay in the same broke place. Because the initiative isn't there. God, see, who is God? He is Elohim. Elohim means creator. Now, he's creating 24/7. And guaranteed he's speaking to his people to create. Say amen to that. And if you're working with God, he's busy telling you something new to do. But unrighteousness can't receive it. You remember the story of the prodigal son, Luke chapter 15. You remember that, right? So what did he do? Prodigal son said, I want mine now. Goes out, spends it all, ends up feeding hogs. Then he said, hey, I'm going home. He said, hey, to be a servant in daddy's house is better than this. I'm headed home. He started going home. Now, his father runs, sees him, runs, hugs him, kisses him. He's still smelling like a hog. And then he says, son who's dead, he's alive again. He was lost, he's found. Come on in. Let's have a party. Let's have a celebration. Get the best robe. Put it on him. Put shoes on his feet. Ring on his finger. Now, let's kill the fatted calf. In other words, let's shed some blood to eliminate everything that he had done in his past. Let's wipe it out from the records. But not only that, let's wipe out the consciousness of what he did. Let's take the blood and apply it to his brain. Let's create new brain cells. Come on now, this is all what you can do with the anointing. And the anointing is on that blood. Let's create, because I remember when I'd hurt my knee, went over there and said, hey, Pastor, we're putting this machine on here. I said, what does that do? It says it destroys the memory that's in the cells concerning your knee being hurt. I said, is that right? I said, them cells can remember that? So, oh, yeah. Said, I said, well, if that machine can do it, the anointing can do it. Say amen. And it will wipe out, folks. I've had people say, hey, I went to my hometown. Hey, you remember when we used to steal them hubcaps? And I was trying to remember. I had to agree with you. I said, yeah, man, I remember. But I didn't remember. I didn't remember. They can make you forget the terrible parts of your past, man. That's what it cripples a lot of people. It, that the enemy brings it up and cycles it through your mind over and over. Say amen to that. So, if you don't play ball with the devil, the next step or the next stop is the furnace. If you don't play ball with the devil. Now, he's sending you, God's sending you into places that they may not like you. I just read that. Am I right about it? But that doesn't make any difference. You're not coming there to be liked. You're coming there to transform the environment. Now, you can't transform it unless you're transformed. Say amen to that. All right. So, if you don't play ball with the devil, his next stop for you is the furnace. Now, what do I mean by furnace? He begins to heat it up. Now, how hot did he heat up the furnace for the three Hebrews? All right, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Okay, Abednego. All right, answered and said unto the king, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer you in this matter. Watch this. If it be so, the God whom we serve, he is is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he what?
Yes.
He what?
Yes.
Now, do you have to say it?
Yes.
Say yes.
Yes.
You have to say it.
Yes.
I don't care what the doctor says. I don't care what anybody says. If they're still working on you, you still got to say it.
Yes.
Say amen. Just don't let it come out of your mouth.
Yes.
Now, I don't care who don't like this. I'm teaching you how this thing works. You will never rise any higher than you're willing to confess. So you gotta say, I'll never be sick another day in my life. You gotta say something. Say amen to that. And what happened is the church many times been talked out of this because they're trying to keep members. But they feel if they say stuff like that, somebody who's in that profession, whatever, will leave. Well, leave, praise God. What I'm trying to do is educate the body of Christ. And I realize that I got to go through the furnace sometimes to get to you, but I'm willing to go through it. Because you're going to be in promised land. You're not going. You're going to be there. You're going to say amen. It's time for, especially black Christians, it's time for the Christian business and black Christians to stop being the smallest business in every city. No, 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 no. You are the children of the living God. Blessing for you, it's for your children, your children's children. Now we're gonna break this mess up, but I'm gonna preach it. Now, okay. All right. Let me just finish this. So the next stop is a furnace. Why? Because you didn't bow. You didn't bow. See, you somehow you compromised, or not you, but somebody compromised trying to get the favor of the king. But the king is running in ungodliness. The king has been saturated by the enemy and trying to. So now what I got to do is I got to go up against the forces of darkness. But God promised you that you will overcome. I said he promised you. First John chapter 5 and verse 4 said that we are overcomers.
Yes.
Look what he says here. He said in 1 John chapter 4, for whatsoever is born of God, are you born of God? Then what are you going to do? Overcome the world. Anything that they throw at you, you're going to overcome it. I don't care what they call you. I don't care how they try to snatch your paycheck. I don't care how they try to fire you, because you're going to end up owning the place just like Joseph and hiring them to work for you. Can I keep going? So the next step is the furnace. Now, what does he control? The enemy tried to control the curse. So he'll try to send the curse out on you. Look what it says in Psalm chapter 73, and I'll start at verse 3, I think it is. Praise God. But just look at this. Watch this. For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the what? Prosperity of the wicked. Keep going. For there are no bands in their death, but their strength is firm. Keep going. They are not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men. That enemy can direct a plague. He can direct some sickness. He'll try to put sickness on somebody who's moving out and so forth. But that's just the furnace. What you got to do is understand that's just the furnace. That you are an overcomer. That you're not going to let this furnace turn you around. And what he did in the furnace, he heated it up 7 times hotter than normal. Well, what is 7 times? Watch this. How hot does a fire have to be to burn you? Come on. Can a match burn you? Now, it's hotter than a match. A match is about 1,000 degrees. But a furnace to forge steel is about 9,000. Why? Because they got to bend steel. They got to fit that steel on your door of your car. They got to fit that horseshoe thing. So they heat it up in a furnace. And that furnace is hotter than anything else. But the furnace is designed that if you don't know God, you can't go through that furnace, because only God can get in that furnace with you. Say amen. And I'm telling you, it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13, this is for anybody who's going through. There is no temptation taken you, but such is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted, tested, or tried above that you're able, but will with the temptation also, come on, make a way to escape, that you may be able to what? To bear it. See, Job was going through it, but in Job chapter 13, put it on the board, please. In Job chapter 13, when he got to his last, he didn't know what else to do. He said, though he slay me, yeah, well, I trust him. And let me tell you, he brought Job out. Look what it says over here when God was reading the riot act to Job. Further over in the book of Job, verse 4, chapter 40, verse 7. He said, gird up thy loins like a man. Let me tell you what he said in Bill Winston's translation. Man up. Man up. You ain't going through nothing. Man up. And I'm telling you, you think you're the only one that went through that? Satan has no new tricks. He's taking people through the same thing. But I'm telling you right now, man up. Your days, your best days are ahead of you. God is in that fire with you. You will not burn. You will not falter. You will not lose out. You will not be ashamed. Just man up. God is about to bring you through.
Well, I trust that you were blessed by that powerful message. Now, this word is not designed to just, you know, just give you a word. It's designed to empower you so that you can do some things you've never done before. Now, here is a part of this particular message you want to strictly make note of. Your inheritance comes only in proportion to your new identity. You see, once we were born again, we're children of God. We're no longer what we were. As a matter of fact, as you go on in the teachings, you're going to see that God says in the scriptures that we've been born from above, that we have his same nature on the inside. So you don't have the same nature as people who don't know God. You're different. And you got to walk in that new identity. Now, the Bible kind of likens us to a lion, if you will. So a lion, one of the things about him is he's bold. I mean, a lion can growl and you feel the ground shake. I'm telling you. So this lion, now he may not be the biggest thing in the jungle, but he thinks he is. So around you may be all kinds of giants, all kinds of giant opportunities, giant obstacles and so forth. Now in your own natural self, before you got born again, you couldn't overcome that. But now you're a giant slayer. That's what you're looking for. Your stuff is wherever it looks impossible. Guaranteed your stuff is right there. Praise God. But you as a lion, the Bible says in Proverbs 30:30, turn not away from any. You are strong and very courageous. Isn't that powerful? Now, today's message is entitled Entering into Canaan. Now, I'm offering a four-part teaching on entering into Canaan. Plus, I'm putting together with that a book called Training for Reigning. Now, that's a bundle that you're going to get. I mean, this is a life-transforming bundle here that I want you to order. I mean, if you're looking to wake something up inside of you so that you, that fear will go away, you'll feel strong and very courageous, this is the teaching for you. Get this teaching. Guaranteed it'll change your life. Well, this is Bill Winston. Until next time, we love you and keep walking by faith.
Today's series, Entering into Canaan, is available in its entirety on CD or MP3, on DVD or MP4. To order, call 1-800-711-9327 or contact us online at billwinston.org. Want additional resources to help you grow? Order Reigning in Canaan Special Bundle, which includes Entering into Canaan 4-part series and Dr. Winston's mini book, Training for Reigning. Order this dynamic bundle today.
came to announce that this is the last day. You gonna go through what you've been going through.
Well, hello, this is Bill Winston. I'm introducing my book. It's called The Kingdom of God in You. Now, this book was put out years ago, and this is a revised edition. I've added some things to it. Now, I believe that this is one of the most important readings in the body of Christ. In other words, when you see Jesus and opening up with his ministry, all he preached was a kingdom. He preached it, taught it, and demonstrated it. Because that's what it's all about. That's why he said, pray thy kingdom come, thy will be done, where? In earth, as it is in heaven. Now, when you're talking about the kingdom of God, notice the word king and dumb. And dumb is domain. And what is a domain? It is a territory under the government of a sovereign or a sovereign ruler. Now, that's what is needed today, because the Bible says that the kingdom of God is in you. If you're born again, the kingdom, whole kingdom, has come inside of you. Now, wherever you go, you express that sovereign government. Once you read this book and get a revelation of the kingdom of God in you, you'll speak with authority that you never know you had. And watch the demonstration of God, because his whole government, angels, anointing, is backing what you say. Isn't it powerful? The kingdom of God in you. This will change your life forever. It'll take you from the bottom to the top. Guaranteed. It's the kingdom of God in you.
Doctors Bill and Veronica Winston are dedicated to seeing lives changed through the power of prayer. Our loving and highly trained prayer ministers are ready to pray and agree with you. We know that prayer can turn around any situation in your life. Contact us by phone at 1-877-543-9443 or submit your prayer request online at billwinston.org/prayer. Follow us on Periscope and Facebook to join us for our regular live prayer sessions. We want to thank our partners who have made this prayer call center possible. Together, we are transforming lives throughout the world. If you are not a partner, we encourage you to pray about joining us in partnership and be a part of the wonderful work that God is doing through this ministry. We love you and look forward to praying and partnering with you. The mission of Bill Winston Ministries is to preach the gospel of the kingdom throughout the world. We invite you to become a partner and join Dr. Bill Winston as he trains believers how to live independent of this world system and have dominion over it. Thank you, Bill Winston Ministry partners and viewers, for your continuous support of the Believer's Walk of Faith broadcast.
Now remember, you need faith to get to your destiny. So don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell so that you don't miss any of our videos. This is Bill Winston. I love you. And keep walking by faith. Walking by faith. Walking by faith. Walking by faith.